And if you do those steps that I just described and you click the link, you will see exactly the step-by-step plan. I promise to you, I just like, this is a guarantee that you will get in the best shape of your life in 2024, finally and for good. All right, so today we're gonna talk about how you can lose fat and get in the best shape of your life in 2024 for good. So we're gonna talk about the steps that you need to have in place before you move on, before you go and try to find the program or step-by-step plan, workouts, nutrition, whatever the case might be. Before you go and try to find that, we need to sit down and spend 5 minutes at least talking about the steps inside this video, right? So take notes and we're gonna get straight to the point. And for those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Vlad Matvey. I'm a National Academy of Sport Medicine certified weight loss specialist. So I help busy professionals, men over 30, 40 years old, lose weight and get in shape without any diets, and really easy to do, right? As well, I have a bachelor in physical education and sport. So today I decided, hey, listen, 2024 is the time for you to actually get in shape. And I guess 2023 wasn't the case, right? Because if it was, I mean, you wouldn't be watching right now this video, right? All right, so let's talk about step number one. So what do you need to have in place before you go and try to find the best program specifically designed for you? So first and first, and I know it's gonna sound boring, so get ready, right? First of all, you need to know exact, you need to have in place the exact goal. What do you want to achieve? So if you can imagine, if we can, you know, say that point A is where you are right now. So you don't like the situation, you want to lose weight, lose belly fat, you know, build muscles, whatever, you know, whatever your end goal is. But before you go and try to find the program for you, you need to know the point B, right? So if you need to go from point A to point B, you need to know the destination, right? You need to know like where are you going? Because most people, and I talk to a lot of potential and clients of mine, and what I hear, because I usually ask them, hey, listen, all right, so what's the goal? What's the end goal? What do you want to achieve? What's the shape you want to be in? You know, do you want to build muscles? Do you want to lose weight? How much weight do you want to lose? You need to sit down and truly focus on understanding and realizing what exactly do you want to accomplish. Because if you have no idea what you want to accomplish, like, you're gonna be doing just maybe the wrong plan that you don't even need, or wrong exercises, or not, you know, you're gonna try some diets that doesn't even make any sense for you based on your actual end goal. But if you have no idea what you want, if you have no idea of point B, where you want to be, right, then it's not gonna happen. So that being said, I get it, this is boring, right? Like, obviously you know what you want. But if I ask you, all right, so you want to lose weight, I usually ask, so how much weight do you want to lose? And a person needs to be like, maybe 10 seconds to think about it. This means that they haven't thought about it like ever, right? They have no idea like how much weight they want to lose. They just say that they want to lose belly fat. They say they want six-pack abs, but exactly how much weight they would like to lose, they have no idea. So that's why before you move on, sit down and realize what is that you want to achieve, and set that as a defined goal. So you want to build muscles, you want to lose weight, and be as specific as possible. For example, in my coaching, what I like to do is, the more specific the goal is, the better for me, because then we know the point B and we can just work towards that. This is as easily as it gets, right? Because we know what exactly do you want to accomplish. For example, it's, you know, 25 pounds you want to lose, right? 10 kgs, whatever, right? You want to build some muscles, get in shape, feel better, right? Lose belly, get six pack abs. So the more specific we can be, the easier it is for us to actually create that plan of action, right? The workout program, nutrition, what have you, so that we know that in 12 weeks or 4 months, whatever, we're gonna get to that point B. So that's why sit down and think about what do you want to achieve, and be as specific as you possibly can be. Don't just say, I want to get in shape. What does that even mean, right? Well, what does that even, like, you want to get in shape? Do you want to build muscles, gain weight, lose weight, become more productive, energy levels? Like, what is that, right? So the more specific you can be, the better. Just sit down and write down, okay, so this is what I want, right? I want to lose belly fat. I want to lose 25 pounds. I want to go ahead and, you know, do minimum, bare minimum of, you know, workouts 3 times a week. So be as specific as you possibly can be. So this is step number one. And this is the most important one, because if you don't really understand what's the destination, how can you even, I mean, you have no idea like what's the plan, what the plan, you have no even idea which plan to choose. You would be doing something like bodybuilder workouts, but you want to lose weight. So it's kind of like, it's going to be a mess. So that's why step number one, pay attention to it. Now, step number two, which is extremely important, right? I get it. All of it important. It sounds boring, but still you need to pay attention to it. Step number two. So you write down, for example, your goal. So this is what I want. Now what you need to do, you need to sit down again for 5 minutes. I get it. It's boring. Get it. And you need to visualize what's the reason why you want to make it happen in the first place. So if you want to lose weight, you want to build muscles, whatever, right? Whatever that goal is, the step number one. Step number two is you sit down and you think, why do I want to make it happen? As simple as that. And believe it or not, whenever I ask somebody, like, why do you want to get in shape? Why do you want to lose weight? They have no idea. They're like, I mean, you know, I just want to look better. I want to be more, you know, healthier. I want to feel just a little bit as if, like, you know, I don't have my belly fat. I mean, it's fine. It's better than nothing, but still you need to go deeper, right? You need to understand truly what's that reason, that burning desire that drives you. What drives you? And it doesn't really matter, even if you want to, you know, people say, I want, like, you know, this summer I want to be like in my best shape because we go on vacation and I want to look my best on the beach. I mean, it's completely fine. As long as it drives you, use that. Because let me tell you something. Step number two. If you don't have it in place, if you have no idea why you're doing it, you just would like to be in shape, here's what's going to happen. You're going to go ahead, you're going to obviously find the program, you're going to find workout program, nutrition, whatever. You're going to start doing it, and then a couple of weeks later, when it actually gets tough, and you completely forgot why you started in the first place, here's what's going to happen. You're going to just quit. And, you know, don't listen to me, just see for yourself in the past, right? If you are not in shape, you've tried something in the past. I believe you've tried something, right? Maybe it worked, maybe it didn't, but then something happened, and as we call it, yo-yo effect, right? So you lost weight, and then you regained that weight back. Welcome to yo-yo effect. So this is what's gonna happen if you have no idea why you're doing it in the first place. Everybody would like to be in shape. Everybody would like to lose a couple of pounds, kgs. Everybody would like to feel better, more energy, stuff like that. Obviously, every single individual would like to be in that, you know, spot. But before you go, you need to understand, why do you want to make it? Do you want, you know, and you need to go really deep. So for example, if you say, hey, like, why do I want to get in shape? You say, all right, I want to feel better. Why do you want to feel better? I want to be more confident. All right, why do you want to be more confident? I want to, you know, so the people perceive me in a different way. I want my wife to perceive me in a different way. I mean, whatever the case might be, you just need to go deep down to find out your personal reason. Because guess what? We're all different people, right? We all have different reasons why we do that. So that's why as soon as you just focus on it, as soon as you find out, hey, this is exactly why I want it, you write down and you keep that in front of your eyes. Because let me tell you again, remind you that when you do it for, you know, a couple of weeks, you know, go by, and you start to feel like a grind and you don't really like it and you forgot why you started doing those heavy workouts, and you just kind of like, you know, do I want to go to the gym or I want to just sit down and watch some Netflix? In those moments, this is where you can, you know, that reason in front of your eyes, this is going to be the only thing that's going to keep you and hold you accountable, right? This is going to be the only aspect that sometimes when you don't want to do anything, is going to just keep you accountable. So keep in mind, find out your reason. All right, we're going to talk about the step-by-step plan, don't worry. But before you move on, before you find your workout program, stuff like that, which I will help you to do, and you need to sit down and focus on those things. So now we go to step number 3. And this is a funny one, because this is why I see most people actually quit. And this is why. So again, we just talked about the point B. So where do you want to go to, right? So what's the end result? The more specific you can be, the better. So if you can imagine, right, we have point A is where you are right now. So you don't like the situation, you want to change it naturally. I understand, right? So you want to go to point B. Point B is your end result, something that you truly, truly want and desire. Now, so what most people don't really understand is that in between point A and point B, there is a huge amount of space and we call it process, all right? So there is a process behind your goal. So this is a tough one because usually what I see, people are, you know, they're pumped and they're like, yeah, I just, you know, so this is my goal, this is the reason, let's go ahead and make it happen. And then what happens, right? Then there is a process and you wake up, right? And you realize, hey, this is what I have to do to get to point B, but it doesn't seem so sexy anymore, right? Point B, obviously you kind of like, you just visualize how cool that would have been if I would just be there, right? In my end result, my body transformation, full body transformation. However, remember that there is always a process to get there. So this is what happens. People set those unrealistic goals, like, I, you know, whatever, right? In an extreme, like, short amount of time. And they set those expectations, but they don't understand what it takes. Because the higher your goal is, the crazier your goal is, the harder the process will be, naturally, because this is how it works. If you want to lose a couple of pounds, okay, it's fine, right? You can do it here and there. Just a few workouts a week, you're going to be good to go. Just pay attention to nutrition and you're fine. But if you want to truly create that body recomposition, something that I do with my clients, it requires some amount of work, some decent amount of work, right? You're not going to be just not doing anything and expecting to get fantastic results. And I get it. All of you understand that, right? This is not like a rocket science. Obviously, there is a process, but this is what happens. They, you know, people go ahead, they create those unrealistic expectations, they get the workout program, diet, whatever, and then when they start doing it, it feels like hell. This is not even like, how can you sustain that over a long period of time to actually get to your end result? This is not going to happen. So that's why realize that when you create the plan for you, when you search for a plan or workout program or nutrition, you need to understand that, can you do that? Can you do that for a long period of time? Is this something that's gonna possible for you based on your job, on your schedule? Is this gonna be possible or not? Because if not, then there is no point to even start because you're gonna quit in a couple of weeks because it's hard. So that's why keep in mind that there is a process and you need to focus on the process, not the end goal. Yes. Step one, we need the end goal, right? We need to set that end goal so that we know which direction to take. We know where we go. This is important, obviously. However, you need to focus truly 100% on the process because this is what's going to get you to your end result at one point of time. So that's why focus as much as you can and do the process as good as you can. That's why I say if you have a workout program, you can't just like have do that, right? You can't just like do this a little bit and then quit and then again, and then you don't really put in the work. You need to be as intense as possible, because what you put in, this is what you get out. The more intensity you do it, this is not just about doing some work, some exercises. This is about how you do those exercises. So again, at the end of the day, the better you do the process, the more you just focus on the process, the better goal will be. And who knows, maybe if you do it truly, if you truly, you know, focus on that process and you do it the best that you can, who knows, maybe actually you will, you know, just achieve even more than you set to achieve in the first place, and you will completely break your expectations. So that's why focus on the process, do it as best as you can, and keep in mind that the end goal is fine, we have to have it, but then just completely eliminate it, just forget about it for a second. You know where you go, right? This is important. But then focus on the process, and if you have those workouts, if you have that nutrition, do the best that you can. Because remember, when it gets really tough and hard, just keep in mind that the more you put in, the more intensity you put in, right, your inputs, the better results you will get inevitably. This is how it works, all right? So that's why focus on the process. Now, we go to the actual, you know, juicy stuff, right? So what do you need to do, right? So step number four, there is only one goal, and that's to get to the calorie deficit. This is the only goal you have. Whether you do your workouts, whether you do nutrition, whether you do diets, sleep, supplements, water intake, whatever the case might be, the only goal is to get to the calorie deficit. So what does calorie deficit mean? Calorie deficit essentially means when we burn more calories than we consume. So we all have the specific number of calories. For example, let's just say out of the blue, like 2000 calories. Suppose this is your maintenance calories, meaning that if you consume 2000 calories a day, you're not going to gain weight and you're not going to lose weight. So this is your calorie maintenance. Now, naturally, if you want to lose weight, you need to consume less calories than 2000 to start losing fat. All right. So the way it works is that if you start consuming, you know, let's say 1700 calories, and all of a sudden you see that you start losing weight, the reason is because you are in the calorie deficit, meaning that your body needs more calories to sustain itself than what you consume. So if you consume less calories and you burn more, not necessarily from workouts, just to stay alive, you will lose weight, right? So this is how it works. Forget about anything else. This is the secret of weight loss. This is how it works. All the diets, all the keto diets, paleo diets, whatever, you know, diets, nutrition, workout program, it all has one goal, specific goal in mind, is to get to that calorie deficit. Only in that case, you will start losing fat. Only in that. You can have the best diet in the world, the best workout program in the world. If you consume more calories than you burn, you are going to actually gain weight. So this is how this process works. Now, when you have that in mind, like, what's the step-by-step plan? Like, what do you need to do to get to that calorie deficit? Because everybody says calorie deficit, calorie deficit, calorie deficit, right? But people have no idea, like, how do you get into that so-called calorie deficit, right? So that's why I prepared something for you, really fantastic. So if you want to have a step-by-step plan, workout program, nutrition, like all that step-by-step, Monday do this, Tuesday do that, Wednesday do that, right? Whatever, just you know exactly what to do, and in the next 12 weeks, which is 3 months, you will get in the best shape of your life, you will lose your belly fat, you will lose weight, and truly get in shape, you will build some muscles. So if you want to know the exact step-by-step plan to make it all happen, then just click the link below this video, you will find the link, click on it, and you will get to my masterclass. It's 1 hour of time, of information, and step-by-step planning, of masterclass. It took me almost a decade to complete it, so please make sure you do it, and it's completely free, right? The masterclass is completely free, and you'll have the chance to work with me personally to actually make it all happen, all right? So whenever you have the time after the video ends, just click the link, you will get to the masterclass and spend some time watching it, because you will know exactly step-by-step plan to do. Now, again, as I described, that you need to be in the calorie deficit in order to start losing weight and get actually in shape, to see those abs, to see those muscles that you have been training so hard, and to truly, you know, enjoy the way you look. Not just building muscle, not just becoming like huge, but truly losing body fat percentage and seeing that you are in shape. So that's what you need, calorie deficit. All right. So again, if you want the step-by-step plan, because I can't just put it all in here, it's a lot of information. So you click the link below. Now we come to step number 5. So this one is, again, I get it, it's kind of boring, but you need to have in place. You need to understand that. Step number 5. Sustainability. You need to have the plan that you can sustain. It's not just about losing weight as fast as possible. It's not just about the best program ever. It is just all about finding the program, nutrition, and workout program that you can personally sustain. Maybe not as intense, but you need to understand that whatever you do right now, you need to ask yourself, is this something that you can sustain for the rest of your life? Yeah, because guess what? You're not going to be, it's not just like the workout program is 12 weeks and you just finish. You don't finish. you need to keep doing it. There is no finish point. Forget about it. We talked about the end goal that, all right, you visualize your end goal. It's fine, but there is no stop. There is no stop to it. You need to keep doing your workouts. You need to keep doing your nutrition. People, this is so funny. Like people, I mean, it's truly hilarious. Like people truly think that they can do the program, the weight loss program per se, for 12 weeks or, you know, 6 months or even 1 year. And then all of a sudden they just stop doing it. And they think that they're going to just, you know, magically sustain results. It's not going to happen. You need to, listen to me, you need to find the program that you can sustain, and so that you can do just a couple of times a week those workouts, at least 2 to 3 times a week. You don't have to be so crazy, but you need to sustain, you need to do something, because as soon as you stop doing it, you will just completely lose it. You will lose your results and you will come back to the shape that you were in the first place when you started. So for that to not happen, again, you need to find something that you can sustain, and the only way for you to sustain that is to actually enjoy it, all right? So whenever you find that program, whenever you find those exercises, it's great to go intense and do the best that you can for a short period of time, but then you need to understand, all right, so is this possible? Is this realistic for me to go ahead and sustain that for the rest of my life? So when you put it in, you know, from that perspective, yeah, you're kind of like, all right, no, this is not going to happen. And it's completely fine if you can't sustain the best weight loss program that you just got. This is completely fine. Just do the 50% of that. This is going to be better. Anyway, just keep doing something and try to enjoy it. Try to understand, as I told you in the step number 2, you need to find a way to enjoy it, to truly enjoy doing those workouts. Most of you, you're not enjoying yourself doing those workouts, or, you know, bench press or high intensity interval training or doing nutrition, right? Counting calories, seeing like what you consume. You don't really enjoy that. But if you look at that from that perspective in mind that I told you, that the more you put in, the more you get out, maybe you'll start enjoying it more, because realize that the better you do it, the better results you will get. So try to enjoy the pain of doing those exercises. Try to enjoy it, because remember that the harder the process is, the better results you will get. So keep in mind, find something that you truly enjoy, even if it's like playing basketball, you will still burn calories, so it's fine. But find something that you enjoy, and then you'll be able to sustain that over the long period of time, which is the most important. So now we go to the last step. So this one is, again, boring, I get it, but you need to have it. And small steps, small consistent steps. So this is the last one. So if you have everything in place right? If you have your goal, if you know exactly what you want to accomplish, how much weight you want to lose, exactly like you visualize, so this is what I want. You know exactly why you want to make it happen. So you know the reason, right? Now you know that the only goal is to get to the calorie deficit. And then you click the link below, you get the perfect plan specifically designed for you. So you have the step-by-step plan. This is obviously something that you need to have, right? And then you understand that what can you do? How can you sustain that? So it's possible for you to sustain. Then the last step for you is just to be bloody consistent. Just to be consistent. And like I told you, it doesn't have to be every day you do some workouts or you do nutrition, but just 3 times a week, 2 times a week. Again, start small, and from that point, you will build, you will get better. Every day you see results coming in, it's gonna motivate you, and you will want to do it even more and better because you see that your body changes. And you know, your loved ones will notice, your coworkers especially will notice, right? So it's gonna motivate you to keep doing it, and keep going at it. So that's why the most important at this stage, as soon as you have everything in place, at this stage, you need to understand that you just need to be consistent. That's it. Consistency. And I get it, it's the most boring stuff you have ever heard in your life. I guess consistency is like everybody says consistency, right? It's like you need to be consistent. But this is it. You just need to do something forever. And you will be good to go. If you do 3 times a week, some random workouts, you will be anyway better than most of the people who never do anything. It's inevitably is gonna happen. So that's why, as soon as you have everything in place, just stay consistent at it. Try to do small steps. You don't have to be perfect, all right? One is better than zero. And if you do those steps that I just described and you click the link, you will see exactly the step-by-step plan. I promise to you, I just like, this is a guarantee that you will get in the best shape of your life in 2024, finally and for good. This is going to happen. So again, do the steps, spend some time on it. Don't you think, get over yourself. Don't think that this is easy and let's do some real stuff. Like let's do some workouts. If you go ahead, start doing some workouts, some program, and you don't have that in place, you're gonna quit. You're gonna just quit, all right? So please pay attention to it, do it, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, whatever you need to do, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Let me know what you want to, me to cover on the next, maybe more in-depth nutrition, workout program, stuff like that. So, leave a comment below this video. I'll take a look. And please act on it and do something about it. And I hope you get the best results this year. All right? So talk to you soon.